another challenge. We're in North Devon this week. We're quite near Barnstaple, and we've been told to come to West Buckland School, which is this beautiful building here, and we've been told to look for the head teacher. Hello. Do you know who's your head teacher?
Oh, Mr. Downwood.
Do you know where he is?
I'm afraid I don't.
That's his secretary.
There's no one in there. Does anyone know where their head teacher is? I think it must be down here. Are you the head teacher?
I am indeed. Good morning. I believe that I've got a letter that you need to read, Anneka.
Really? A letter from Amber Gatehouse and Ben Gatehouse.
Now, where is Ben? Ben, would you like to come forward, please?
Ben, what's
this is
going
Amber
on
here.
Hi, Amber. Is this your letter? Ben, what have you been up to? Let's read the... Does anyone else know what's going on? Shall I read you the letter? Dear Anneka Rice, we challenge you to refurbish a derelict barn into a boathouse for use by families with disabled members at the Exmoor Calvert Trust Centre, Wistlandpound. And is it really as bad as you
well,
say here?
Yeah.
So what's it like?
Well, like an old farmhouse, which is almost in ruins. The children are disabled and they go there to stay with their families and they take up the facilities that are there.
But there aren't any facilities.
No.
So.
I've actually got a challenge for you, Anneka.
Here we go. Have you seen this on telly before? Can we get a challenge? Complete Ben and Amber's challenge in time for the first children's regatta at 3 p.m. on Thursday. PTO, most of the children coming to the regatta have never sailed before. Ready about. Done. If at 3 o'clock you come and give us a big cheer if we manage to complete the challenge, is that all right?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
You'll definitely be there.
Yes.
Don't forget.
Wistlandpound.
Yes.
Go to East Buckland Cross, which is half a mile that way. Turn left.
Head north.
And in 8 miles you'll see a sign that says Wistlandpound to the left.
Get that, Paul?
I think so, yes.
Good. Okay. So we'll see you on Thursday.
Okay.
Thank you very much indeed. Well done. What have you got now? Chemistry?
Chemistry.
Have fun.
Oh,
what have you got then? English. Oh, I'm so glad I'm not at school. I think I'd rather dig a hole. Bye-bye. I'm sure there wasn't a right in there somewhere.
I always thought you was listening to the right bit.
Playback, Dave.
Tables at this
table. Go on out here and cross the full crossway and way on again, and then you hit the main road to Ilfracombe, and you continue on out there to it's Blackmore Gate, and it's where you turn off to go to Linton and Lynmouth. But you go down then on your left, and that takes you down to Wistlandpound.
Wistlandpound Farm. Is this it? Hello.
Jeremy Holton from the Exmoor Calvert Trust.
Hi.
And I'm Jonathan Rind.
Who are you?
The architect.
Oh, right, brilliant. So you're actually the charity representative? Or...
Yes, I'm the chairman of the management committee here. The object of the charity is to provide adventure holidays for disabled people, their families and friends.
Right.
And we provide canoeing and boating and all sorts of outdoor activities on Exmoor.
So where is the water? Is that...
The water is over there. The reason we need the boathouse is because at the moment we're having to carry all the boats down to the reservoir each time we sail. Bit of a challenge in itself because of the conditions of the track. But the idea will be that wheelchair people will be able to get down to the reservoir under their own steam.
We feel it's quite important to be able to do it independently. Really.
I feel a bit of a path coming on. Is this what you're trying to tell us?
So we're going to have a path that's to the correct gradient that makes it user-friendly for wheelchairs.
So that means sort of zigzagging across this area of planting here at the moment.
This is getting ridiculous now. I cannot believe you've been operating even up till now. Just physically getting people up and down here.
It is a problem we've had to manage so far, but we can't continue like this for very much longer.
I'm more concerned about Martin's boots.
In fact, actually, Jeremy and I were just on our way down to the boathouse to meet Stansels, who are the builders who did the farmhouse, and that was finished in at Easter this year.
Sorry, I know we've only just met, but this is
delightful.
Hello!
Right.
Oh, you're from Stansels.
Hi. What are you
doing here? John Williams.
Good.
And Chris Spear.
See, this is the old cattle barn, and the far side of it is even worse, actually. It's, there's no roof there at all, and it's all rotting down. And what we're wanting to provide is sitting areas. We've got some plans here of, look at it this way, a sitting room in the first three bays, and then changing rooms, showers, loos, a bathroom. And then at the back, just sort of boat storage, but with doors on it so that it keeps it for its secure, and an equipment store.
Excuse me, this isn't a boathouse, it's a sort of hotel.
Well,
this is ambitious. But I mean, from your point of view, from you guys' point of view, just the access to this is going to be a nightmare.
We've got to start on the track right away.
Yeah?
We need to put the track down so we can bring down the equipment.
So you can't actually start on the barn until the track's down?
Not really, but we can start on cutting some of the trees down.
Right.
We need the Forestry Commission to actually cut down some of the large trees so we can make the slipway down to the reservoir. That's
right.
Another job we've got to do.
Why are you looking so calm? What are you on, and could we have some? Can I have a quick look at the reservoir itself?
You want to sort of beat away through the nettles.
So presumably we need to
There's a better track down the other side.
Well, we never go for the easy options.
Mind the sting there.
Actually, let's go for the other track. Sorry. Wasn't it beautiful? What a setting. This is heaven, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And we hope that it's going to be heaven for an awful lot of disabled people.
Right. What about saying 3, 2, 1, go?
Why not? 3, 2, 1, go.
Dave, what does that noise mean? No service round here.
Good morning, Progressive Systems.
Hello there, who's that? This is the position, Dave. Remember, this is the only position along the whole of the reservoir.
Hello.
Is that rapid scaffolding?
Yes, it is.
What are you doing in the background?
That's moving some scaffold.
Oh, right. Is any of that scaffolding you're moving as we speak available?
I think we could possibly help you there.
Do you think you could?
How much you need.
How much do we need? A few poles, bit to go around the corner, and some for over the roof. If you could possibly help us, we need tree surgeons to trim back and lop some trees as soon as possible. Mr. Waller?
Yes?
We're doing a project down at Wistlandpound Reservoir.
Hello, I'm afraid I can't hear you very well.
Can you hear me now?
Only just.
Is that better?
No.
No.
Hello?
Is that better?
Yes, there.
Right, just there?
Yes.
Right, we desperately need things like hardcore and chipping.
Right, oh yeah.
And I just wondered whether you'd be able to help.
I would think so, yes.
Really?
Yep.
Oh, Mr. Waller, you're our kind of man. Bedlam on the other side of the reservoir, so we've come over to the relative calm and tranquility this side. This is where we can see what the Calvert Trust is all about. There's a group of kids who've just arrived from a school in London. They're here for a week and they're about to have their first sailing lesson. Hi there.
Okay. Hello.
Hi. Good to see you all.
We were actually given a challenge this morning to make a boathouse and a proper path down to the boathouse so that when you come on holidays here in the future, there'll be proper access for you and, you know, it'll be a lot more organised and complete. The other important part of the challenge is that we're meant to have this whole project finished by 3 o'clock on Thursday afternoon, at which time there's meant to be a regatta. And you have got to be the stars of the regatta. So you've got 2 days.
Right, well, this is Rob Paget, our chief instructor.
Hi, Rob.
Today.
Hello. Good to meet you. Hello. Hiya. Well, listen, don't let us get it away. You've got a lot of work to do, I think.
So when you go on the water, it's just going to be an introduction to what it's like to sail. Okay, we've got just ideal wind today. It's a nice, not too blowy, okay? Mm. It's nice and dry. And we'll just try it out there. Okay, we'll have an instructor per boat, and then after a while, then we'll try and start doing a bit of helming and that kind of thing, ready for your regatta.
Do they expect you to rig your own boat?
Well, I hope not, because I can't reach it.
Have finally given up on us, so we've taken to the road. We're off to find some building supplies. The good news is the sun is out, it's a glorious day. The bad news is the weather forecast is dodgy. Rolled-edge worktop.
Bet we have.
All right. I bet you haven't got a back inlet gully and cover.
Bet we have.
Right. How about this one? What about high-low damp-proof course?
On the lorry.
What's the point? By the end of today, the hard course should be laid all the way along this track to the boathouse, which is that strange and interesting-looking building at the end there. Oh my God, no, 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 no! Oh my God, oh my goodness, no, 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 no! Oh my God! My knight in shining armour, thank you so much, that was so gallant. Could you just stand there for most of the afternoon in case I have to go backwards and forwards?
Give me a show. I'll give you a fireman's list.
What's your name?
I'm a retained fireman as well.
What's your name?
Andrew Spear.
Andrew, retired fireman, is in
charge.
Could you possibly lift Dave over, that chap there, because he never wears the right shoes? Talk us through it.
We've had to revamp it a little bit. They cleared this very early on. This part of the roof was nearly gone anyway. Timber. Around the other side, actually chopping up all the branches and disposing it out the other way.
I've never seen a transformation happen so quickly. That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Yeah. That's the sound of the men
the chain. Gang all day long they're saying, put on, put on, put on, put on.
Derek here is coordinating the regatta on Thursday. So yep. Derek, what should we be thinking about? What do we need to do?
Well, you need some gear for the regatta, like marker buoys, so we've got something to aim for to sail around. You need anchorage for them, something visual to have on the camera, like a lot of balloons going up, sound signals going off at the start. The boats aren't banned for them. They could do really with a better boat. And there's specific boats they use for this sort of group.
What
things like Drascombe Luggers is an ideal boat.
What's that?
It's about a 16-foot boat. It's an old clinker design with three big red sails. And you can actually get three or four kids in at the same time, as opposed to just one or two like here. They might get groups in the future where they can't get out of the wheelchairs at all, so they might have to take the whole chair in the boat.
So these luggers are solid and big enough to actually put
really
a wheelchair
are. Yeah,
in them.
Really solid they are.
Right.
They're ideal boat for these sort of things they want to do.
Well, I don't know about the boat, but we'll have a go at the pontoon and we'll have a go at the klaxon and I'm sure we'll get the balloons. But more than that, I don't know.
It's worth a try.
It's Anneka Reiser from the Challenge Programme.
Never heard of you.
I bet you wish you hadn't right now. We're doing a challenge for the Calvert Trust in Devon, and we need a floating pontoon 2.5 metres by 9 metres.
Right, what sort of waters is it on?
It's a reservoir.
Okay, it's relatively sheltered.
It's very sheltered. It's a nice sheltered spot. I'm sorry to have a laugh in my voice, but it's impossible to make a mobile phone call in Devon, so I've come into the middle of the reservoir on a boat to do it.
OK. Right. Yes, I have got pontoons of that size.
I mean, how heavy are these things?
3.5 tonnes.
3.5 tonnes? So we'll need a crane.
You will indeed.
Have you got one?
No.
But you know a man who does.
I know a man who has.
Has been dug right from the top of the hill. It'll go all the way down to the boathouse. It's desperately important because this is where all the services will go. There's AI cables for the electricity, Southwest Water and BT. It's important to have a telephone line in case there's any kind of emergency down on the reservoir. And this will be taking place throughout the night tonight. It's horrible down here. And remember this morning, this was the muddiest area of the whole lot. Our boots literally sank down about a foot. It's now covered in hardcore. The problem is we're actually short of hardcore by 300 or 400 tonnes, but we've just heard. Thank you, Devon County Council, for coming to our rescue. Excuse me, how are you?
Fine, love, thank you.
I just wanted a small question I wanted to ask, is why is there a river running through the sitting room?
Because we had a lot of rain yesterday. We'll divert it, you see.
Okay, I thought it might have been an attractive feature.
Oh, it's a damn nuisance. It's a damn feature.
Now, it's now 8:30. This is the actual Calvert Trust farmhouse where families can come and stay. And you can probably hear the noise in the kitchen. I think supper has happened. And our sailors are getting ready for bed. Hi there. Good evening. Hi there. Where am I? Is there a gap there? Is there a gap there? So how are you feeling after today?
Fine.
Yeah? Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
What was the best bit?
We have to turn around on the boat.
Sailing the worst.
It's really good. We have to use a tiller and you have to go all the way around and then the thing comes over and then he hits you on the head.
I nearly went in because of it.
My
dinghy,
darling.
What?
My
dinghy,
darling.
You don't
want to? Would you have liked him to have gone in?
Yes, he would.
The thing is, there were cameras on this, so I've gone in.
You could have gone in with the cameras on. Excuse me, that's perfectly allowable. The only thing you're not allowed to do when the camera's on is swear. Sorry, no swearing. You have to be on best behaviour now. Please. Such beautiful countryside around here, don't you think?
Yeah.
It's just gorgeous. I mean, where do you normally go on a family holiday?
I went away to Buckingham, my back room's run here, and they wouldn't let me go on any rides, so they told me I wasn't allowed to go on any of them.
What is your particular problem?
Cerebral palsy.
Cerebral palsy. Mm. And what does that mean you can't do?
I can't. I need something to help me walk. And I can do everything else.
And how do you find people react to you generally?
Well, at some of the things around my house call me spastic and that, when I go out, but Mum just says, take no notice of him.
And how do you cope with that?
Not very well.
Do you still get really upset?
Mm.
Doesn't get better as you get older?
No.
So what's your reaction?
Just don't be it.
When I was about 8 years old, this boy called me out, because I'm handicapped, this boy pushed me over to the ground and cracked my head open. So.
Cracked it open?
Yeah, because I was handicapped.
What is your
handicapped?
Cerebral palsy.
Cerebral palsy. I didn't crack it open, it started out very easy, and it still beat me up now.
And do you find that because of your physical problems, people assume sometimes that you might have a mental problem?
Yeah, but like some people, like my mates and that, when I first moved to my new house, they used to think like I couldn't play football and stuff, so I used to say to them, if they'd give me a chance, I'd soon prove them wrong.
Hmm.
And in the end, I did.
What's your disability?
I've got spinal bifida.
Right.
And hydrocephalus and scoliosis, which is water on the brain, which is I've got a valve tube that runs from my head right into down to my stomach, which keeps the fluid pumping around my brain. And scoliosis is I've got a curved spine that goes like that.
Right. And do you find that people are cruel to you?
If anyone else don't like it, that's their problem.
Because you can't do nothing.
And I said that to someone once. If you don't like it, that's your problem.
Yeah.
I'm like this all the time, so just leave me alone.
And what do you want to do with your life? What's your sort of career plan?
I'll study arts when I go to college. Yeah. Art and music.
Yeah.
You study art? No way.
Oh, excuse me.
Poaching,
correct.
What bit do you do?
Well, we're pumping the concrete from the road into a concrete pump all the way down these pipes and into the job.
How exciting. I've never seen it coming out of a pipe before, have I?
This
is a bit of a new one on me.
Well, it's been around many, many years, and it's been used a lot in the construction industry.
Martin, we've never seen it coming out of a pump, have we? I'm sorry, it's the first on challenge.
Well, there you are, then.
What have you got to do now?
Well, we put the concrete in, then we what you call parflow, so it get nice and flat and a bit of a shine on it.
No.
So, as long as it's there, the rain keeps off, it should be OK.
Challenge nightmare. It's now midnight, the concrete's gone down, but it does need time overnight to set. As you can see, though, the heavens have opened. It is absolutely tipping down. And this is really going to have a very serious knock-on effect now.
Darkest clouds are in the sky. You must
mustn't sigh and you mustn't cry. Spread a little happiness as you go by. Please try.
Good morning. Well, I'm afraid things didn't get any better overnight. This is absolutely miserable. But the concrete slabs have now gone down. They're starting work on the roof trusses, which is going to be really difficult in this rain. I think the irony is we've had a telephone call for help from the Exmoor search and rescue team. All I can say is I think we're going to need them. They've offered us bodies to help. We could do with a few dingers as well.
What's the use of worrying and feeling blue when days are long? Keep on smiling through. Spread a little happiness till dreams come true. Surely you'll be wise to make the best of every blues day. Don't you realize you'll find next Monday or next Tuesday your golden Tuesday. Even when the darkest clouds are in the sky, you mustn't sigh and you mustn't cry. Spread a little happiness as you go by.
Sausages and bacon in there. Bats, what's in there?
Tea.
Tea, hot tea, all mod cons. Wouldn't you like to come and volunteer to work on a challenge as well? We love it.
What's the use of worrying and feeling blue when days are long? Keep on smiling through. Spread a little happiness till dreams come true.
Now, I heard a rumour that you'd always wanted to get involved with a challenge.
You're right.
Really?
Every time I watched you on the telly.
You wanted to join in?
Yeah. I still can't believe I'm doing it.
And are you really regretting it now?
No.
Really?
No. Just keep laughing. And if we keep remembering them people in the wheelchairs, we'd like to be here doing it with us, wouldn't we? So let's do it for them.
Spread a little happiness as you go.
Well, it's good to have you on board.
We're putting this track is really hard and rough. Dangerous for a wheelchair. It's hard work.
To push the wheelchairs up as well.
Like, you see my friend needs to be out coming up here.
Where the track goes down, you tip out your chair like I did yesterday. Because, you know, like when you get the flat bit and then you get the tire tracks, as you're going along, slip off the tire tracks and go, I nearly ended up down there.
Right, good morning, everybody.
We're on to helming now and going about. We've got to get ourselves ready for the regatta, okay, which is tomorrow. We've got a lot to get through, so I want to see all hands on deck, okay?
Yay! Okay.
Who do you think's going to win the regatta? When you're ready, let's go back. Ready? Cross? Good. Excellent. Right.
There are still a lot of things we urgently need. One of those things Derek from South West Water asked for yesterday, though I don't know whether we've got any chance of getting it, and that's a special kind of boat. It's called a
Drascombe Lugger.
Drascombe Lugger, whatever that may be. There's apparently only three places in the entire country that make them. So we're off to the seaside. Weather is just a complete and utter nightmare. I mean, it is soaking wet.
It's raining again. I'm hearing it pitter patter down. It's wet in the street, reflecting the lights and splashing feet.
We've got a leak right here.
Oh, there's the sea. How depressing it looks. So wet and dribbly.
I
can feel my troubles running down, disappearing to the silent sound. Just walking along.
Ah, boating centre? Do you think? How'd you get in that shop, do you think?
I come all under here, you get an excavator, they got them over there, you get an excavator and you dig them up and you come under there and you come up inside there. That's how you get inside there.
Thank you very much.
I can say there is no better place than standing up in the falling down. In so much that I could almost drown.
Hello. God, it's miserable out there, isn't it? Absolutely disgusting. I wonder if you could help us. We're doing a challenge.
Child of a destiny, not from eternity.
Cornish's unit.
Oh,
that'll
do, you won't it?
That'll do.
I'll give you a... Look, do you think they'll get this done by tomorrow?
No.
Oh, what a shame.
If they do, I'll be shocked.
You'll be shocked if they do it.
We're going to have to work all night. We're going to be finished by 2 o'clock tomorrow. So they won't get any sleep again tonight.
What is this bit for?
What's it for?
What's this
part? I don't really know,
Dana,
I honestly don't
think it's a boat, actually.
I don't know what we're doing. We just do as we're told and hopefully at the end it'll look good.
This is our demo boat.
There's really? A new one just about to be launched.
Beautiful. Do you know what? We need one of those.
Am I blushing or something?
We don't like to put people under that much pressure. We do think it's cruel. No, but seriously, I mean, that's a lot of money, I know.
It is, isn't it?
What do you think, Vic? Well, we certainly can't do it.
We can't do one for tomorrow. So.
Could we have... We couldn't have that.
I think the short
all the
answer is yes.
Yeah.
Wonderful.
Oh, that, huh? Yeah.
Yeah,
careful of
cattle
for us. Yep, that's it. Once more. You do the job for us, huh?
I'll stay all night, won't you?
Be ready to move in for you tomorrow.
It better be. if this ain't ready, we won't be doing our challenge.
We won't let you down, we'll be ready right tomorrow.
We've got a change as well.
Yeah?
We got a
sour
boat.
What a difference an hour ago, literally an hour ago, this place was obliterated by rain. You couldn't even see the opposite side of the reservoir. Now you can easily make out the work going on the other bank, and you can also understand why people love to come here on holiday and just how important this whole project is. We've got great excitement on this side of the reservoir now. Our pontoon has arrived, a huge great crane. It's about to be lowered into the water and floated across to the work on the other side. Yes, I gotta have faith. I gotta have faith.
How'd you do it?
Have a particular fascination in the cesspit. Clarkester have been along and they spent hours I'm doing the sound now, am I? They've created this thing and all that's to show is this little manhole cover.
Yeah, that's right.
And Dave, being a sort of cesspit freak, is determined to open it up and see what's happened underneath.
Let me just drop this end of it because my fingers
are in there.
Dave, can't we just describe it to you?
Okay. Yes, I gotta have
one
of the major parts of the challenge, one of the most complicated tasks, is actually making the zigzag path, and you can really begin to see it taking shape now. Has it been fun?
Fun? Well, I'll put it this way. I had a job to sleep when I did get back last night because I was so bubbled up with excitement. And I still is now.
Really?
Yeah.
What's the fun bit of it? It must have been a nightmare. It's been pouring with rain and freezing cold for most of it.
No, you don't worry about that. You just shut that back in mind, you see, and get the job done.
Yeah.
We've just been talking on the meal break there. And this is hoping to finish because I still want to let you down. And we don't want to let them little kids down.
Oh, you don't want to let the kids down too soon. So you'll be there.
That's it. You know, even if we walk up, out in the road at the top at the end and just collapse, so what? We get it done.
On a challenge and we were completely wiped out. And I must say, this time last night, I thought exactly the same thing was going to happen again. But thanks to some incredible hard work, and I have to say, some real ingenuity at the local quarry, for example, every time a lorry turned up from anywhere to pick up anything, it was sent down here to the challenge site with another load of hardcore. So we've got everything we need. It's going to be a long, long night tonight, and it's so important that this challenge really finishes on time, because as Susie, one of the girls, one of the children up at the farm, said earlier today, the children really can't start their challenge until the workers here finish theirs.
I've got is the levels here are too great to put steps in.
Yeah.
So I've got to make the pedestrians walk around the first two loops of the ramp.
My other Ironman we turned up with no screws. 3 o'clock this morning, everybody's trying to hang doors with no screws.
Now, the other part of the challenge, of course, is the regatta, which is meant to start at 3 o'clock this afternoon. And we've got over 200 people coming to watch, I think, unless it rains. So, bunting, Dave?
Some cakes.
Yeah, thanks, Dave.
Sandwiches.
Band or something would be good. Let's make a bit of a list.
Easy coffee.
Anyone out there wants a job as a sound man, we need a new one.
Get last year's
white. On this side of the building, you can really see how it's going to look on the other side, hopefully, in a few hours. We've got all the timber cladding up. Bolton and Paul have provided, still wet, all these doors and the windows, and there'll also be shutters on either side, so it should look... This is going to be the bathroom, we think, maybe. Look, there's a loo. Oh, it's Roger. Hey, Roger.
Still here.
I've got problems. Some seats. We need some seats for changing, you know. My only hope is if I can get a stand to joinery at Taunton, our own in-house company, and ask them to make them by 3 o'clock. I'm desperate.
6 hours to go.
We're struggling.
That's the understatement of the year, I think. To Barnstaple to try and get some of those supplies. Dave, what was it we needed?
Lots of sticky cakes, cream horns, Swiss rolls.
Donuts,
chocolate cake, biscuits, sandwiches, teas and coffees.
You've never had a job at the WI, have you, Dave? Do you know where there's a bakery?
A bakery?
Yeah.
End of the high street.
Oh, is that?
Yeah, if we go down to Mermaid Cross, end of the high street.
OK, thanks a lot. Cheers. Bakery. Oh, that's a restaurant.
Hello. Is there a bakery?
Bakery?
Downtown.
There's one down on the left-hand side, about another 150 yards, Warren's.
Hi there.
Hello.
Have you heard we're doing a challenge? Oh, we're trying to get local bakers to see if they could perhaps give us some buns or cakes. Or
we do pink ice buns and sticky buns.
The pink ice buns sound perfect.
Pink ice buns, OK.
Mark, look at this. What about a trophy? Hi there, does anyone know of a local band who might be free this afternoon?
No, we're on holiday.
Local band?
A local what?
Band.
Band. Pass. In there might know.
Do you know of a local band?
No.
You don't know anybody who's got a brass band or the address that I can contact over? Brass band for Anneka Rice, over.
We can say we tried.
Just remember, Derek asked me to get some balloons if we could for the regatta.
Hello, celebrations and ballyhoo balloons.
Celebrations and ballyhoo balloons, woo! What a name. It's Anneka Rice here from the challenge programme.
Is this real? Nobody's taking the mick out of us here.
No, I promise, it's me. I promise.
Okay,
do you want
Marian
to talk to Dave?
No, it sounds like Christine, doesn't it? Right,
it's
okay,
not Christine.
We'll help you if it's genuine, we'll help
It's not
you.
Christine. Here, talk to Dave.
No, it's a real one. This is Anneka talking to you.
Right.
No, that you're Dave.
Oh, no, I'm Dave.
Yeah.
Sorry, I'll hand you back to Anneka. It's very confusing.
No, Dave, you're Dave. Sorry, that was Dave the sound man.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, I think so. Yeah, we'll help you.
Look at this, the bath is complete. Oh, that bit's not.
Don't worry, it'll get done.
The benches.
Just arrived.
Oh, here, the 11th hour, well done. Just an hour to go now, it seems impossible that all this hardcore has got to be leveled and then flattened before the wheelchairs can come down. Well, the zigzag path is nearly complete, as you can see. This is the last corner and then we meet a problem. There's this huge pile of hardcore here, and this lump has got to be taken on down the hill, right the way down to the boathouse, all in 45 minutes.
Come on.
Right, well, it's almost time now. The path isn't actually finished at the bottom yet, but the idea is that if we get everyone on their way down, by the time we get to the bottom, hopefully they will have finished.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello!
Now, are you ready for this?
Yes!
Good, let's go. Right, path's just round here.
That's it, we're done. Last cap.
That's the last little I'm doing today.
Right. I don't know why all the workers are applauding, because we should be applauding you. I can't tell you what this means to everybody. You've performed a miracle. I just cannot believe it's finished. So I think we would like to congratulate and thank the workers, wouldn't we? OK, guys. To everyone, the charity said to us at the beginning of the challenge, they're finding it very difficult working with small boats like the Mirra Dinghy, and there was one particular boat they needed more than anything, which is a boat called a Drascombe Lugger, and I'd like to say that you've got one.
Oh,
and it's on its way down. It's just so overwhelming, I'm sorry. It's wonderful. Ben and Amber, we're going to invite you as our challengers to start the first Wistlandpound Regatta. Are we ready to count down?
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, you're so pretty. We'll see you at the next challenge.
Right on.